A closed and rigid tank has a volume of 0.4 cubic meters and contains water at 0.75 bar with a quality of 80.3363%. If the pressure goes up to 2 bar when heat is added, what is the initial temperature, what is the final temperature, and how much heat was added during this process? Remember to solve this problem yourself before watching the solution to make the most out of this exercise. This is the first example for the enthalpy and internal energy 12-minute lecture video. The links to the other examples on this topic and the other lectures of the thermodynamics course are found in the description below. The process to solving this problem is very similar to the example from the main lecture video, so make sure you've watched that one before proceeding. Just like in that problem, we know that our water is in a saturated mixture state since we have a quality between 0 and 100%. We can go to our saturated water tables by pressure to find that our water must be exactly at the saturation temperature of 91.76 Celsius for it to be saturated. And that's T1. Using this table, we also write down Vg and Vf and use the quality expression to find the current specific volume, particularly for that quality value. With this, we find that the specific volume is 1.781 cubic meters per kilogram. Since the constant mass of water is in a rigid tank, meaning same specific volume, V2 is this same value after adding the heat. With P2, we look up the specific volume for a saturated vapor, and since at 0.88578, the saturated vapor specific volume is lower than the current specific volume, we can conclude that our water is in a superheated vapor state. We go to our superheated tables, look for a pressure of 2 bar, 200 kilopascals, or 0.2 megapascals, to find that for a specific volume of 1.78142, the temperature is 500 C. And that is T2. Now, to calculate the heat that went into the water, we carry out a slightly different process than that of the previous example. We still want to calculate the change in internal energy, and for that, we need to calculate the change in specific internal energy and multiply that by mass. We still use UF and UG for 0.75 bar to find the specific internal energy at state 1, with the help of the same quality expression, only this time using the specific internal energy instead of the specific volume. We write down UF and UG, and we calculate U at 1. Now for state 2, we don't need to find quality values. We know that our water is superheated, and therefore, at that pressure and temperature, the specific internal energy value is given by the table. This would be U2. Since specific volume is volume over mass, we know that mass is the given volume, 0.4, over the specific volume we got, which by the way is the same for state 1 and state 2. With this value for mass, we can finally calculate the total change in internal energy, and therefore the total heat. If you want to check out the other, more complex examples for this same topic, the main lecture video, or other lectures of the thermo course and other engineering courses, make sure to check out the links in the description below. Thanks for watching!